Hello, good evening, all of you online guys.
या गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
राइट, सो प्लीज शेयर योर मेल आईडीज एंड फोन नंबर्स इन चैट बॉक्स, ऑल ऑफ यू। हेलो यस्टरडे एक्चुअली एज ऑफ द फर्स्ट डेमो सो आई कवर्ड ऑल दिस टॉपिक्स। I would like to recap 5 to 10 minutes. So yesterday is what we have discussed. Then after we'll see this practically. How can we interact with the databases by using SQL? How can we interact with the databases by using SQL? We'll see. See, yesterday, what is mean by the data and data formats, data storage solutions, data presence in database, and familiar database vendors. Then overview of the database, that is we have discussed as of the first demo. See here, what is mean by the data? Data is unit of information or it's a collection of information about some object. Maybe it is in a number format, image, video format, a different formats. Data will be presented, then it is going to be described something. Today, if we are stored something, then tomorrow, then we can see what happened yesterday. So that is, we call it as a data in this. Then, whatever data, if we are selected in a world, okay, that should be commander in three categories. Structured, unstructured, and semi-structured format. So that is yesterday we have discussed. Once if we are decided data, whatever data if you want to store, where we are going to be store this data, where we are going to store this data, that is we call it as a data storage area. According to the data, according to the system, wherever we are going to be keep the data. So that is in digital information or a digital format. In a structured, organized manner where we are storing the data. So that is, we call it as a data storage area. Okay. Majorly here we have two different formats are there to store the data. First one is a file format. Second one is database format. It is. File formats are available here. Lot of file formats are available nowadays to store our data in a document format or either in PDF format, Excel format, and JPEG image. Image is also the data. Today, if you are taking the selfie, then later, after 1 year, 2 years, then we can see So the image, 1 year back, what happened, then we can realize here. That is also the information. But here, file level, if you want to maintain a data, some disadvantages and advantages, both are there. If it is a file, copy paste is very easy. Simple, we can copy and we can paste the data. And we can move the file from one place to other place easily, cut and paste. But those are advantages. Whenever we are coming to the disadvantage, file is not going to be handled. Okay. More volumes of data. Whenever we have more volumes of data is there, that is not possible to control in file systems. Huge volumes of data. Trillions and trillions of transactions are going on. These are all transactions if you want to be controlled in one place. So, for example, the business is a bank. In one day, trillions of transactions will happen throughout the world. All these are all transactions if you want to store or maintain in one place. So, file system is not suitable. So that to control this data easily, then they are introduced here, database management systems, DBMS systems. So this is, we call it as a database management system. So this is also the tool actually. Under this tool, we can store our data years and years and years. Today, if we are created, keep on, then we can load the data into this same area. Trillions of records we can maintain in one place. We can organize in one place easily. That is, we call it as a DBMS, database management systems. See here how the data will be presented in files and databases means. Different file formats are available, like text file. This is the pure text file it is. We can store in the data in text file like this. And this one is image, okay? Paint. Under paint, then we can store the data like this. This is IS, of course. This one is also data. This one is also data. In Excel, pure in a record format, manually we can store. And PPT, PowerPoint presentation, slides. So how we are showing now. This is the way the slide format. Yes, complete demo, we are arranged in a slide format. This is also the data it is, okay? So in files, the data will be presented like this. But in database level, how it will be presented means, if it is a database, either in two-dimensional or in multi-dimensional format, this is, we call it as a table. And this one, we call it as a cube. Okay? Multi-dimensional format or two-dimensional format. Two-dimensional format means x-axis and y-axis. So cube format means, and we can see here a z-axis also. Three-dimension or four-dimension or five-dimension. In pure array format, we can store our data, okay, in databases. Only the database is going to be store here, the data in two-dimensional format or multi-dimensional format only. That is called as a structured data only. The database is going to be allowed only the structured data. Okay? So, okay, fine. We are decided to store something else in database. So, or else in a file. How can we store the data or in system level? How the data will populate? The data is going to be populated like this through application integration or else a manual entry or file import, or ETL process, or a replication. This is all we have discussed yesterday. These many ways we can populate the data into the system. Then after database, what is mean by the database? Organize the collection of storage. So in one place, we call it as a database. It is lot of databases are available here now. These are all our familiar databases in world. Oracle DB, Microsoft. Microsoft is providing two databases. One is SQL Server. Second one is Access. First one is Access. Second one is Microsoft SQL Server database. IBM Corporation is providing DB2, NetAzure, Informix. So, and see PostgreSQL, MySQL, MongoDB, MariaDB, Cassandra, all our databases only. All our databases. Okay. So these are all we call it as a databases. Finally, what we can store here is we can store the data in databases. Whatever the database, according to our requirement, whatever database if we want, then we can select and we can work with that database, just like as our tools bikes. So this is we all discussed yesterday. But if you want to say something to the database, or if you want to interact with the database, what we required finally? Finally, then we required a structured query language is required. This part is required. Okay. Anything else, if we want to speak with your database, insert the data or delete the data or retrieve the data, these are all operations. So if you want to work with your database, any database, it is either Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, MongoDB. So not MongoDB, MySQL and PostgreSQL. These are all what we require here is structured query language is required. SQL is a language for what? For to speak with the database. Okay. That is what we are going to be learn this SQL part. IBM Corporation is introduced in the 1970s. So to speak with the Sybase database, then after, this one is included in ANSI standards. All databases are going to be follow the same language. Once if I know the language, then we can speak with all databases. That is what. That doesn't matter what technology we are going to be involved, or either a data scientist or a data analyst or a BI analyst, BI developer, ETL developer, or if you are an expert in application developer, all people require the knowledge in SQL part. Exposure, not intermediate knowledge also. So they are expecting nowadays. So in exposure knowledge on database, SQL part, query writings, okay, we require here. But here the talks will vary. See here, how the talks will vary. All of you online guests, Vishnu, please mute your system. I will give you the timeline to for your queries. All of you online guests, please share your mails and phone numbers under chat box. Then only then I can share you two demo videos and content. What we are going to be committing here to be covered. Pure SQL part and the basic documents. To understand the basic fundamentals, I will give you the documents. Please share your mail IDs and phone numbers under chat box. Okay. This is the part actually yesterday we are discussed. Today then we'll see how can we communicate or how can we interact with these different databases. Actually in my system, two databases are installed. One is SQL Server. Second one is Oracle. It is CNO. So if you want to interact with any software, what we require first of all, system is required. Right or wrong? So under system, what we require? Platform is required. OS is a platform. Operating system is required. If you don't have an operating system, then we cannot communicate with the system. Right or wrong? OS is not there. Or otherwise, your smartphones, take your smartphones. Android, what is the Android? Android is operating system. If you don't have Android, then we cannot communicate with phone. Right or wrong? Hardware and software both together, then the machine is going to be work here. Whatever the instruction you are asking, that instruction is going to be sent to the peripherals based on this OS operating system. It is here, different operating systems are there, Windows and Linux, Unix, Mac, Android, like this. Any one operating system is required, machine is required. Then here, then we can go and we can install all software tools. Whatever tool if you want to interact, or either Excel or Power BI, or I'll say SQL Server, anyone. So then here, then we can go and we can install it. Right, wrong. Otherwise, it's not possible. Must and should, what we require here is, if you want to install SQL Server in your machine, first system is required, and the system level operating system is required. Then here, SQL Server and Oracle DB, both are there in my machine, under my system. Microsoft database name is called as SQL Server. Oracle database is called as Oracle DB. Both databases are in my system. So now I am expecting to open and connect to this or speak to both databases. We'll see. First of all, then go and open a Oracle database. See, if you want directly, then we cannot speak with the engine. Database is called as a engine. Don't ask me to show the engine. It's not like bike engine, it is. Okay. And just it's an algorithm. Algorithm, once if you are installed database, then algorithm engine, database engine is going to be loaded in system level. So what was the proof is, this was the proof. Come to the services. All services in a machine level, in our system, all services. These are all our services are there in my system. See here, these are all are related to Oracle database. And these are all our SQL Server. See, so services are running here. And same way, the Oracle service is also running. Oracle service is also running. And Microsoft database SQL Server is also running. Means, once if we are installed the database under machine level, service or database engine, first of all, is going to be loaded in a machine. But directly, then we cannot speak with the engine as an end user. I'm an end user. Okay. So I don't know here machine language. This is a database engine. If you want to speak with this engine direct, then we cannot interact it. Here the mediator is required. That is called as GUI, graphical user interface, to interact with this server. Anything else, if I want to send any talk, any request if I want to send it to the SQL server, then they are providing one type of a GUI that is called as SSMS, SQL Server Management Studio. SQL Server Management Studio is a tool. Again, this tool is going to be communicate with this SQL Server database. This was the communicator between me and server. See here, then go and open this one. Whose tool it is? Microsoft database. Microsoft tool, SQL Server, SSMS, SQL Server Management Studio. For what it is, means to interact with your database engine. Anything else, if you want to speak with the engine, must and should we need to connect here through SSMS tool. Connect it now. Now then it is going to be established the communication between me and server. Then I can speak anything else. Whatever I want, then we can go and we can speak with the server. See here. SQL server name is called as SQL May249AM is a server name. With this server, if you want to speak, then click on new query window. Here I'm asking something else. See here. Lot of databases are available here. Now see this query. I'm asking Pure. For example, I'm asking like this. Go and get back employee table data. Okay, pure English language. Then this is a request. This request I am going to be execute here. See what it is asking. Clearly it is saying what you are speaking. Then it is providing you the error message. And what you are speaking, I can't understand, boss, what you are saying. That is the message here. Yes, from here onwards, if you want to say something to the server, it should be in a grammatical format, in Excel SQL format. It is structured query language format. See, I am saying like this, select a star from EMPM means, but already you have a table. Table means two-dimensional data arrangement. Previous somebody's else are already created and already they are stored something else. Today, then I want to see this one. What is the meaning of this query is, select the data from this table. Star represents everything. All columns from this table. Columns from the table. This is a request. So this one is my request of this. If I'm looking this request 100 years, server is not going to be respond. This request we need to send to the server, then only the server will respond. How we are going to be send this request to the server is through execute. Select the query, then go and execute it. Then immediately within a fraction of a second, then it is providing a request response. It is this one we call it as a request. Okay. And this is we call it as a server response. It is user is requesting, server is responding. So then automatically the server itself, it is going to be extract all the data. How many records? So 110 records are there in this table level. Already somebody else, they are already stored 110 records here. Each 110 employees information. Okay. So this is the manner then we have to speak with this server. This is, see, what database it is? Microsoft database, SQL Server. Microsoft database name is called as SQL Server. Okay. But I want to come down with Oracle. See the Oracle here. One more database it is. Now come to this one more database that is called as a Oracle DB. Oracle database also having a GUI that is called as SQL Developer. It is Oracle SQL Developer to speak with Oracle Engine. So this is also having the environment like this, see or not. So both SQL Server and Oracle, both are there here. See now, almost both are the same. Now, here also one more database is there. Click on this, then this one is asking a password. Connected to this. Yes, see here. This one is also showing a lot of objects, tables, views, indexes, and then functions, procedures like this. This SQL Server is also providing tables, views, programmability, stored procedures, functions. So this tool is different and this tool is different. This is providing by the Oracle Corporation and this one is providing by this Microsoft Corporation. Two bikes we are discussing, that's it. Okay. And this one is whose database it is? Oracle database it is. This one is whose database? Oracle Corporation database. If you want to maintain your data in Oracle, then go and purchase this Oracle database. Go with that. And if you want to work with SQL Server Microsoft database, then go and purchase the Microsoft license and work with this. That's it. Features will vary here. But language is not going to be vary. Functionality is not going to be.
Syntax is same.
Syntax is same. Clear. Here also I want to ask, see this one. Here employee EMP table is not there. Employee is there here. Employees.
Yes.
Name is changed.
Then
same here also I am asking to get back the data. Employees. See here. Here and here I am asking same select a star from. EMP is a SQL Server level object. Here, employees is Oracle object it is. Then select and then go and click on run it is. Now, request we send to the server, then server is responding same way. See now? So, speaker, language is same language. Here and there, we are speaking with the same language. Okay. But what happened here is the capacities and features will vary. Maybe Oracle is going to be provided a lot of objects here. And SQL Server is going to be provided here. These are only the objects here. Okay. So feature only will vary. The remaining functionality and language both are same. Okay. See, this one is ANSI standard syntax, not Oracle syntax. Not SQL Server syntax it is. The syntax is providing by this American National Standard Institution. All databases to be follow the syntax.
It is similar.
Syntax is similar it is. Okay.
Once you come to know, so we can mail it two subjects.
Two, yes sir. Yeah, here if you are going to be learn, here also then you can go and you can write the same code. Okay, right. See now. So this is the way then we can communicate with this service. And this is the way then we have to be learn this SQL part. But according to this role, actually job role, based on the job role, talk will vary. How it is means all are SQL only. For example, Telugu. Telugu is a language. If I'm entered into the police station, okay, Telugu only, they speak complete words, case, investigation, theft, these are all the subjects, right? If I'm entering into the bank, there is no thief and investigation. Their subjects will vary and terminology will vary, talk will vary, right?
Transaction.
There also, they are using the language is Telugu only. In police station also, they are using the Telugu only. But their communication, their words and their speak well. Same way, here also, according to the role of the job, if you are an application developer, some sort of activities we need to involve more. If we are a BI or data analyst or a data scientist, then our talks is different. See, here, what kind of roles actually? What kind of people? What kind of roles we need to learn this SQL part? Majorly here, developers, first of all. All kind of developers, application developers, okay? Application developers means who are experts in languages, Java, PHP, Python, Django. So these people's job is to create applications like IRCTC, Book My Show, okay? So Amazon or ATM Center application. How they are going to be create this application? They are going to be create the application by using these languages. Whatever the user is going to be interact with the application, that should be connected to the database. Something we are doing in ATM center, withdraw the amount. After withdraw the amount, what happened? This one is going to be collected the information from the card. So card number, so on, so details, card details, what is the time and how much he withdraw and which branch it is. Every detail it's collected from this application, then it's going to be loaded into this database level. So that these people also require database knowledge. If they want to collect and insert the data, what needs to be done? Load data. Okay, that is what. So application developers also require SQL knowledge. And then after ETL developers. So who are experts in Informatica tool and ADF, Azure Data Factory, so SSIS, SQL Server Integration Service. So these are all our ETL tools. Extract, transform, and load. Their job is collect the data from homogeneous, heterogeneous data. Transform this data and load it into one place. These people also needs to be connected with the databases. And then pure BI developers, business intelligence developers. So who are experts in Power BI or SSRS reporting tool, Tableau, like this. These are all our business intelligence tools. Those people also needs to generate a report. If they want to generate a report, what we require data is required, where the data is presented in database levels. They need to extract the data. All kind of developers are required this knowledge to load data or to extract the data or to so maintain this data. And but this application developers is going to be interact with load updates majorly. Their job is collect the data from application and then go and load it into transactional DB. But ETL developers and BI developers job is already the data is there. Then again, extract the data and show in a report format what happened previous. Then these people require here more data extractions. These people are more data loads and these people are going to be involved more extractions. In database level, not only load and extraction, lot of things then we can do it. Data security we can provide to the data, okay? And data loads, one place to other place migrations. Okay. So these are all kind of things. Then we can do it on database level. Not only just maintenance, migrations, ETL, analysis. Okay. So these are all things, security. These are all things, then we can do it on database level. That is what we require this language. This is we are going to be learning how to speak with the server. According to our requirement, as an application developer, ETL developer, or a BI developer, how can we speak with the server? That is we are going to be learning is called as SQL. The ones perfectly, if we learn this language, then we can speak with any database, right or wrong. Perfectly, if you learn the driving, then you can go and you can drive with any bike. Same process here also. So on the top of the developers, actually here, all data scientists, data analysts, whatever the role it is, all developers required. So knowledge is called as SQL, backend level SQL is required. On the top of the developers, admins will be there. Admin. This is one of the role. Database admin he is. Means these guys are only control for the security, backup and recoveries, permissions. They are going to be provided. These people are going to be maintain the databases. Yes. Today I am a joined to the enterprise. Okay. Then they need to provide this one, this database access. How they will provide? According to my role, they will provide the access. If I'm entered into the bank, so, or a bank cashier, or a bank clerk, don't have access to this, touch this locker rooms. Right or wrong? According to the role, then, so the permissions will get in enterprise level. The same way here also. Okay, so according to the role, the admin are going to be control the access, data security, or else backup and recovery. Something is wrong happened, they are going to be get back this previous things. That is admin. And one more is there, super admin is. On the top of the admin, super admin will be there. So this guy's job is, super admin job is, control the all servers, configurations, component level performance. Means this database is going to be filled out tomorrow. 100 GB we are assigned for one database. Means one room I am assigned 100 GB. The room is going to be filled. Then immediately they need to catch this point, which room is going to be filled here. Any kind of unnecessary space allotted, those are all spaces they need to be clear, or else if it is required, okay, then they need to be go and purchase one more room to be installed to this server. So, and how this performance, database level performance, CPU, how much CPU components, all components are perfectly utilizing or not. For all resources, this is all controlled by the super administrators. On the top of the super administrators, see database architects or data warehouse architects. Data warehouse architects. These two roles will be there. Architect means, yes, this is already designed and this database already having object. Before going to construct a house, simple example, what we are going to be doing, we are going to be, first of all, interact with the civil engineer. As for our purpose, civil engineer is going to be give you the plan, how you want to construct the building. Right or wrong? Same way here also. Database architect or a data warehouse architect is going to be decide. So how the database should be created, and where it should be created, what database is required here, and what kind of objects are required. That is all architecture is designed by this architects, database architect or a data warehouse architect. So these are all people are civil engineers. They will give you the plan. According to the plan, then we are going to be construct the databases like builder mistries. You are all are builder mistries, right? So we are the developers, yes. According to their design, then we have to be create the database here. So these are all roles will be presented in servers. Not only one person, all roles are going to be involved in a single day. All people are going to be interact with the same server only, same database only, onshore, offshore. Both will work parallelly, so on the same server. Admins, super admins, and architects and developers, all will be there here only. No, according to the role, the server is going to be provide the service. So server can handle, okay, according to the role, it can serve the same time to the multiple services. So at a time, morning 9:30, 100 members are asking a question. 100 members' questions are different. Then it is going to be provided which one is asking which query. According to that, then it will respond. So first come, first serve basis, it will provide the service. Server will provide the service. Okay. So this is the way parallelly is going on. See this architecture here, server once if you are opened. So the once if you are open a server, here we can see all these objects. SQL server, databases, security, server objects. These are all features the SQL server is providing. Okay. Here also Oracle is providing all these features it is providing. And once if you are open a database, again here so many databases are there. Again, if you are going to be open this, here then we can see the lot of objects. So it is simple like as our room construction. See, this is your house. Okay. Under house, this one is one room. Under room, these are all our objects. Different rooms are there here. Technically, here we are calling, this one is a server. This one is a database. And this is called as objectivities. Okay. If we have a one house, we are going to be divided like this house, residential block. Bedroom, kitchen, hall, okay? Like why we are segregating the space like this? This is a master bedroom. Why we are dividing the space into multiple rooms means to control the objects easily, to maintain the objects easily, then we are going to be segregate like this. All kitchen objects should be there in kitchen only. We are not going to be place this kitchen objects in hall or bedroom level. Yes, easily to manage this. Yes, if you are going to be placed in one area, then it is very difficult to be control this object. That is what they are segregating the rooms here. All yes, if we are going to be find out something object, kitchen object, directly we are entered into the kitchen only. Right or wrong? So that is the way then the container they are going to be created here. This is one of the container, it is server. It's nothing but a room, it is one house. Under house, different rooms. This is purpose is different. And this purpose is different. And this purpose is different. Okay. This is only I want to store HR information only. Once if you are entered there, only human resource data only presented. And once if you are entered here, employee information is going to be presented. That is called as database. Database is nothing but it is a container to store your data. Okay? Whatever data if you want to store it. Then we can go and we can load n number of objects. These are all our database objects. Okay. Object is what means? Yes, object to control the data. Table. Yes, want to store the data in table form. So what we have in a table level data is. So this table where it is presented means the database level it is present. In one container, one room level, the table is there.
Each database separate.
Separately, we are like this, a number of databases according to the server space you can create. Same architecture here also. See, in Oracle, for HR information, they have created this. Right? Once if we are entered into this database, what we have only human resource data will be there with. So this is the way then we can interact with servers. But see, one more. I want to create one new table. See here. Table is nothing but two-dimensional data arrangement is called as a table. Table is what? Table is nothing but, see here. Two-dimensional data storage, x-axis and y-axis. If I want to store something else, my new data I want to store here. Then here I'm going to write a command, create table. Here I'm saying to the server, I want to create a table. Table name is called as account table. That is the identification. Today we are creating. Tomorrow, if I want to call the data, name is required. Yes. So that then, okay, fine. Table name is there. What do you want to store in a table level? I want to store in a table account ID, simple information, numerical value. Yes, must and should we need to specify what value it is. That is called as data type it is. Or we should inform to this server what kind of value you want to store in that column level. That is called as a structured data. Aadhaar ID, pure and numerical format only. Then only we can arrange in table. If it is changing, Aadhaar ID is changing, account ID is changing. Sometimes it is character, sometimes it is a number, sometimes it is image. We cannot fix in table. That is what? So then I am saying like this, account name. So character format. Maximum, I am expecting 30 characters only. So this is my table. Only account ID, account name I want to store for 10 employees. 10 accounts. Then this is called as a table. Go and send this request. Command completed successful. Means table, account table created in OLTP database level. See, two columns. This is all we'll see. Just for command, we are discussing this. I will explain in detail. Same command I'm going to be copied. And then go and paste over here. There is no change. Same command. I'm executed in SQL Server. Same command I'm copy and I'm going to be executed. Oracle. Then go and see. Executed. What happened? Table account table created. Here it is saying command successful. Here the Oracle is saying Basur table is created. Whatever you send the request, the request is successful here. Then here also, then I want to see. Refresh this. Is there or not? Account table is existed in Oracle. Account table is there in a SQL server. But this house is different and this house is different. Okay. In two houses, I am created two bedrooms. In two bedrooms, I am placed the bed. That's it. Right, wrong. Okay. So this is the way then we are going to be interact with the server. According to our business logic or according to our requirement, then we have to speak. The request we should send to the server in an understandable form. Okay. So this is the syntax. SQL language syntax it is. If I know English, if I'm speaking where, which, where, there is no meaning. Grammatically, we should follow, right or wrong? Same way here also. If you want to speak with the server, grammatically send the request to the server. Then the remaining part complete, the server engine will take it. This command it will take, then it will execute, analyze what the guy is asking. According to the request, then it is going to be executed. Is the way then we are going to be communicate with this databases. Not only, yeah, that is all we'll discuss data warehousing. Different databases are there. Different data is there. Okay. That is all I will discuss in regular sessions. All databases. Okay. What is mean by the transactional database? And what is mean by this data warehouse, analytical database? That's all we'll see. These two are Oracle and SQL Server databases. Then, same way, then we can go and we can talk with the Teradata. And same way, then we can execute the same query in MySQL also. Okay. So this is the way the communication will happen to this. Yeah, little bit of syntactical variations will happen. Okay. But not much, completely command is not going to be varied. Little bit of variations will have varied. So then this is the way all of you online guests who are not shared so far, your mail IDs and phone numbers, please share your mails and phone numbers under chat box. Then only you will get. So demo videos and documents. Phone number is also mandatory, guys, please. Okay, then. So these are all what we are going to be committing here is this was the deep content for SQL Server. These are all the topics I am going to be covered here. Two parts, SQL and TSQL. Or PLSQL, it is procedural language and SQL language. I will share with you this content. So this is, I'm going to be commit. See this one, each and every topic clearly otherwise is mentioned. And
development.
See now, document one, document two, practical documents like this you will get. For every topic, practical documents you will get like this. Then almost we have the topics are there here. So 26 topics or mostly 28 topics are there. Okay. In deep with project explanation and day-to-day activities which you have to done on enterprise level as a pure SQL developer. Okay. So, and real-time database environments and what are the challenges you have to be faced and how to overcome this and performance tuning. Okay. Some issues, but I wrote the query. Whenever if I'm going to be executed the slowdown, then it is processing. See, it's not like the deal of 100 records, 1,000 records in enterprise, the deal of trillions of records. Same query, suppose if I'm going to be executed in enterprise level for one table, select a star from product. Okay, product table having 10 trillion records. almost it will take to see the data, complete data, it will take more than 8 hours. Okay. So it's not within fraction of seconds, it is not going to be populated the data. Slow down, then it will come. Okay. 10 years of data is there. You are asking select star frame means everything.
Yes,
everything it want to get back. Lot of time it will take. Okay. So these are all. If it is slow down, it is running. The business is asking, the client is asking, or so higher official is asking, there is any chances there to decrease the performance, means time. So that is called as performance tuning it is. That is all the techniques then we are going to be discussing. These are all the topics, each and every topic in deep we are going to be discussing here. Okay, practically. I will share with you the content. According to the content, every topic is going to be covered. And materials for each and every topic, practical documents for each and every topic, then I will share with you like this. Practical 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the project. So, and interview questions. So everything I will go and I will provide you. And these are all the complete. We are going to be covering this course. 2 parts, not 30 days. Don't expect 30 days, guys. It will take around 45 days. It will take to be finished. Okay. So daily 1 hour session. Fixed timing it is 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Or if you want any morning batches and all, please go and inquire the reception. They will inform you. So when the morning batch will start. Then Monday to Friday, the session will run. Saturday is optional. So 2 Saturdays, then I will take the session. 2 Saturdays, it's completely practical. It is for your doubts. Whatever I am doing here, that is yourself, you have to do it on the fly. Yeah, if I'm asking some question, then you have to write the query, then you have to submit it. That is this practical means. Saturday, only it is interaction. Now, I am not a principal here. Okay. So that's a complete interaction. So that is, I will ask the question, what are the topics Monday to Sunday, Friday is covered. On those topics, then we'll go for the discussion it is. So then after then project explanation, I will give you the project. Only explanation, guidelines I will give you. This is completely, you have to do it yourself. Complete material, requirement, everything I will provide in a project level. Queries, procedures, then yourself you have to be implemented. So, and this is the way the training will go on. From tomorrow onwards, the regular session will start. These are all the topics we covered in SQL part. And this one is second part is there. This is called as a TSQL or PLSQL it is. Procedural language. In Oracle, we call it as a PLSQL. In SQL Server, we call it as a TSQL. It is
same methodology.
Same methodology, same. So they see, and we are going to be providing your materials. Each and every day, live video session, practicals, and FAQs, I will share with you. Okay. So at the end of time, if you want any help to prepare the resumes with your base technology combination, Power BI or SQL, how you had to place your SQL part in your resumes, or plain SQL developer if you want to. So try for that, then I will give you the guidance. Resume preparation, then I will let you know. SQL Server connection via internet, public IP address. I didn't get the points, Srinivas, here.
Sir, does this course require any software to download?
That is all, leave it. I will show you how to install the softwares, everything I will provide. Okay.
No, sir. Like, in order to arrange the lappy, so I'm asking. We are using office laptop, so is that possible in that?
Okay. And your office laptop you are using?
Yes, sir.
My office laptop, if you are using, then we are not having any setup actually to practice this server. We are not sharing. It's a simple server. You can install it. If it is not possible to in, so maybe I think you can install this SQL server in your machine also.
Okay, sir.
I will show you. If you have an office laptop is there, then we'll see how to install, or otherwise then you have to
arrange
some other mission. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Or else,
sir,
if you are available and the lab is there here, okay, morning from 8 to 8, then you can go and you can come down here. Then we are going to be providing a system, dedicated system for you to practice.
Yes, sir. Sir, what about this one, sir? Data mining, evaluation, and visualization of the data. Like, well, it comes under SQL only?
No, no, no. It's not related to the SQL part. That is related to this Power BI.
Power BI, yes, sir.
No. We are going to be covering here data modeling. Modeling means how to prepare your database. Okay. How to relate objects to objects. So data loading, data extractions, rules, protocols, how to maintain the data integrity. Uniform data, how can you maintain? So how can we avoid the redundancy in these tables, duplications? So these are all we are going to talk here. So presentation and all, visualization, presentation, all are you are going with. So
yes. We need to extract the data by using queries.
Exactly.
Okay, sir. What about case studies, sir? Case studies.
Yeah, that is I'm saying. Each and every week, then I will give you the practical case study.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, anything else apart from this online, guys? So please share your mails and phone numbers who are not so far. Share your mail IDs and phone numbers. And if you have any questions, please raise your questions. Or else if you want to speak with me for your career doubts or any doubt related to the subject, guys, this is my number. So call me after 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. and between of 8 to 10, or else in the morning after 12 to 4. Okay, these are my time limits. Please call me in that time for your doubts and all. I will clarify. Right. Thank you all of you guys for to attend this second demo. My reception will get back to you for further confirmations. Tomorrow onwards, the regular session will start at 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Okay. Thank you all of you online guests.